Hole number one is a 356-meter par four. This is a fairly conventional opening hole, a hole which demands only extreme accuracy. It's an opportunity to limber up the muscles and focus the mind for the real challenge to come.
That'll play.
Bite! Nice bird.
Hole number two is a 365-meter par four. That tree in the middle of the fairway can either be a blessing or a curse. Take aim on it and shape your drive with a touch of draw, and you will finish in the perfect spot from which to approach the green.
That's on the short stuff.
Go in the hole.
Nice shot.
Nice bird.
Hole number three is a 158-meter par three. From the elevated tee, the hole plays about a half a club shorter than its actual length. The dangers are plain to see, and the green is a generous-sized target for this length of shot.
Too much club. Nice par.
Hole number 4 is a 489-meter par 5. This is Valderrama's signature hole. A good drive and second shot favoring the right-hand side will finish in the ideal spot for an approach shot to the elevated green.
That'll play. You're dancing.
Nice bird.
Hole number 5 is a 348-meter par 4. Don't be deceived by the widest fairway on the course. This is an accuracy hole, calling for precise placement of the tee shot, usually with an iron, to line up your pitch with a narrow entrance to the small green. A tree threatens shots attempted from the right side of the fairway.
It's in the deep stuff.
Nice shot.
Hole number 6 is a 149-meter par 3. This is a massive green for a modestly sized par 3. The target area is restricted, depending on the sighting of the cup, if you're going to leave yourself with a desired uphill putt.
Great shot. Nice par.
Hole number 7 is a 421-meter par 4. This hole has gone through several changes of character. At one time, it was a par 5, which the pros played as a par 4. Then it became a par 4 for the members, who played it mainly as a par 5. Now it is a formidable par 4 for everyone.
Be the club.
You're dancing.
Nice bird.
Hole number 8 is a 315-meter par 4. In a strategic sense, this is the same challenge as the 5th, only on a reduced scale. You must first identify the area of the large fairway that will give you the optimum line through the guardian trees for your pitch. An iron from the tee is usually the sensible choice.
It's in the rough.
Great bird.
Hole number 9 is a 403-meter par 4. Originally, this was the 18th, so the standards are demanding, commensurate with a closing hole. A long second must be played through a narrow chute of trees to a heavily defended green.
Got a hold of that one. That's on the short stuff.
Sit down.
Nice par.
Hole number 10 is a 356-meter par 4. Now the screw really begins to tighten because the second half demands greater accuracy in shot making, particularly in controlling fades and draws. A touch of fade off the tee will leave your ball dry and in good position for the pitch shot to this elevated green.
That'll play.
Be the club.
You're dancing.
Nice bird.
Hole number 11 is a 500-meter par 5. The best line of play is up the left side of the sloping fairway of this legitimate par 5. Or at least make sure the ball is up on the left after your second shot so you can get a clear sight of the green for your pitch.
It's in the rough.
Nice par.
Hole number 12 is a 194-meter par 3. A high fading tee shot is usually the preferred tactic here. As you stand on the tee, you might assume this is the hardest par 3 on the course. Actually, that pleasure is yet to come.
It's in the rough. Good save.
Hole number 13 is a 368-meter par 4. Accuracy rather than length off the tee is demanded here. The trees on either side of the fairway are not thick, but it's still a lottery if you hit in among them. This green in particular bears close study before you decide on the line and speed.
Got a hold of that one.
Slow down!
Nice try. You can have that one.
Nice par.
Hole number 14 is a 338-meter par 4. There is a slight kink in this fairway. From the tee, it may appear that the best line is along the trees on the right, but actually, the preferred angle for the approach is on the left side.
That's on the short stuff.
Hurry! Get there!
Nice shot.
Good save.
Hole number 15 is a 206-meter par 3. The tee shot will need your longest iron or a wood. Hitting this long, narrow green is only half the battle, as the contours of the green are severe and most deceptive.
Get legs.
Nice shot.
Good save.
Hole number 16 is a 386-meter par 4. Here again, in the manner of the 14th, only half the fairway is the effective plane area. It is one of the keys to the understanding of Valderrama that the straight holes are best played as slight doglegs.
You crushed that one.
That'll play.
Nice bird.
Hole number 17 is a 467-meter par 5. By shortening the hole and creating a lake in front of the green, this hole has become visually more exciting and tactically more demanding of the players. Now the decision must be made. Lay up short of the water or go for the carry and the sure reward of a birdie.
You crushed that one.
That's in the deep stuff.
Be the club.
You're dancing.
Nice bird.
Hole number 18 is a 415-meter par 4. Here, the tee shot is paramount. A drive can run through the fairway and into more trees unless the shot is drawn to a precise degree. Prudence may call for an iron off the tee, but then you are left with an extremely long second to the tightly trapped green.
Get legs.
Good save.